Hello guys, welcome back. So in this video we are going to understand the next question that we have on the in the contest that we have seen in the Saturday contest, right? So I have thought to put the code, but unfortunately some problem came in my laptop, and then so I decided to go with today morning. Okay, so let's understand the questions. So the question we have is find the power of k size subarrays second. And it is saying that first we have already uploaded subarray 1, we have already uploaded, so please go and watch the video so you will get that idea about how what we have to do in this program, right? So otherwise if you have not aware with the first one, so let's continue with this, and you can go after the watching this video. Okay, so the question is saying that we have given a array of integers, right? That is called nums, means we have given an array and we have a size n, there is a positive number k, and the power of array is defined as how the maximum element of all its element are consecutive sorted in ascending order, right? Or otherwise minus one. So if you have observed in the last video, what we are doing actually, we are finding all the sub arrays, right? And then on the sub arrays we are checking is it consecutive or sorted. If it is, then we will find the maximum element and we have to return, otherwise we are returning minus one, right? Once and then we are putting all those in a result set, and then we are returning, right? Now we are saying we have given, you need to find the power of all the subarrays of numbers of size k, right? Means we have to find all the power of all the subarrays, okay? And once we have got the nums, right? And then we have to return the integer results, right, of n minus k plus 1, and then result of I is the power of this, right, that we have already seen in the last video. Okay, so what does mean it is saying, right? So you can see the example here. We will discuss this in the next slide. So you can see here in the example one, we have given nums, we have given, then we have k we have given, right? That the statement was saying. So how we are getting this value? So we have to find all the subarrays, so there will be the 5 subarrays like this, right? Then we have to decide the maximum element. So how we're going to find the maximum element? So first we will check the consecutive and the sorted. So if you observe these two having a sorted and consecutive, right? So the maximum element will be 3 and 4. But these three are not consecutive. In that case, we'll say not consecutive, not sorted, not consecutive. In that case, we will return minus 1. So you can see this value, right? So the goal, what is the goal, or you can say what is the intuition of this program, right? So if you have observed already the statement and the example, right? So you have understood the goal of the code is we are going to find the last element of every k elements, right, in the subsequent within an array, right? Means we have given this array, so we have to find the subsequent elements, right? And then we will create the array, subarrays, you can say, right? So our goal is to find the last element of the every k elements subsequent within a array, right? Means if I'll talk about the 1, 2 and 3, so what is the last element? 3 will be the last element, right? So we will find like this, and every k element subsequent within a array where the you can say elements are consecutive and sorted, right? So the what are the approaches we can do, right? So we can take a sliding approach, window sliding approach, right? So we are the, you can say, solutions, like we used to slide a window, right, to traverse the array, right, and we'll check the k element consecutive, right? So if we'll talk about some element, let's suppose we have 1, 2, 3, right? So we will consider first these two, and then we'll consider these two. Means first window will be this, and the second window will be like this, right? So like that, we will use a sliding window approach, and we'll traverse the array, and we'll check for the k elements, which is consecutive and subsequent, right? Then what we should do? You can also use a startup sequence. So if you heard of a sliding approach and SOS, right, startup sequence, right, then it is very easy to implement this program, right? Otherwise you can also use a window adjustment, right, and then we can do, right? But these features we have to implement in this program, right? So first of all, we'll start with the sliding window approach, right? Then we'll go with the start of the sequence. We'll create some variables, right? And we'll keep track of the start of the current subsequent, we can say. And if the element is not consecutive within the previous element, then we will update our sequence. Like that we will do, and we will find the we will do the window adjustment, right? So how we are going to do, let's see. So first of all, as you can see here, right, we have given the class, we have given, right, and we have given the method signature where we are getting nums and array k, right? So first of all, as I told you, we will create a startup sequence, right? So we will have our startup sequence here, right? And we will start with the zero. Means this is a SOS variable, and we will track the start of the sequence, consecutive sequence, and then if the element is not consecutive, right, then what we will do, so we will check with the previous element. Consecutive means we will check with the previous element, and then we will update the SOS, right, and we'll say like we are updating the start new sequence from the current element, right? So let's begin from here. Then what we will do after that, we will create a result because it is required to store all the element from the subsequence. It is, if it is consecutive or sorted, right, then we'll have the last element and we'll put there, or maximum limit we can say, we'll put here, otherwise we'll put -1. Then we'll then you can see we are filling the array with the -1, right, and otherwise we'll replace the value. We have index 0. Now what we should do, we should apply the sliding window approach, right? For the sliding window approach, we have to start from the index 0, and there will be some end. So there is a start and end should be less than equal to nums.length and end plus plus, right? We will reset the start SOS if the current element is not consecutive with the previous one, right? If the current element is not consecutive from the previous one, then we will reset the start. We will start with reset 0 and we'll go to the end. Means, as I told you, 1, 2, 3. So let's suppose first subsequent will be this one, right? First window is this, right? So this will be your start, and let's suppose this is your end. So end will start, and will also start from here, but end will move here, right? But the start will keep tracking of that. So we'll check if the current element is not consecutive, right? Let's suppose 2 is not consecutive, it is 5. Then we will reset the start, right? And then we, for that, what we have to do, we have to make a condition and end not equal to 0, right? If nums at end not equal to the nums of n minus 1 plus 1, then we will reset SOS equal to end. Means we are resetting the start of the start, as you can say, if the current element is not consecutive with the previous one, right? Now we have to ensure that SOS is not there before the start of the pointer, right? So SOS is less than start, SOS equal to start we will do, right? So if we have a valid k element, consecutive element, we will store the last element. How we are going to do, we will do n plus 1 is greater than or equal to k. If k is less than or equal to n plus 1 always, right? Or we can say if k is equal to n minus SOS plus 1, right? So in this case, if we have a valid k consecutive sequence, then we'll store the last element. How we are going to do, n minus k plus 1, and we'll store last element, right? So we are adjusting here the window, or you can say, so we will keep track of the window, right? The window is we will define the window using the start and end. And so we will slide the window through the array. We'll do the subsequence check. If the sequence is only considered valid, right? Right. Then if the difference, we know, end and SOS, right, equal to k minus 1, right? Then only we'll have the window length exactly equal to k, and all the elements are consecutive, right? Means if the sequence is only considered valid, right? So if the difference between end and SOS is equal to k minus 1, right, then it means that you can say window length is exactly k element, right, equal to k, and all the elements are consecutive, right? So we'll store the last element and we'll say Then we have to slide n minus start plus k, and we'll keep track of start plus plus, right? So the result will be, we have to populate the result, right? So if the current window is valid and the last element of this window is stored in the result array, then the result array is initialized with the minus one and will mark window, right, where k length is consecutive and wasn't any element found there, right? If it is not there, then we'll have our result and we'll keep adding the last element and we'll have the result. So if you'll talk about the complexity, right? So if you have observed this problem, right, and statement, right? So we have created a solution, right, and we have iterated over the array, right, with the once with the sliding window and then the time complexity O of n, right? So if you have observed that we are moving with all the elements of the element of the array, then obviously it will become what, O of n as a time complexity. You can see the for loop we have, right, single for loop we have. Then each element we are processing at most twice, right, and so we at least say O of n times we have the time complexity TC. When we are talking about the space complexity, right, the additional space that we are using through the SOS, right, start and end, and the index is constant. So overall space complexity is O of you can say n, but we are also moving of the moving on the size of the result array, right, size of the result array. Because if you observe here, we are created already a results and we are storing the data here, right? So nums length we are storing, so O of n dot length is n element minus k, and plus one we have already taken the size, right, and that is why we can say space complexity is O of n minus k plus one is the space complexity, right? I hope you enjoy this video and you understood this video. And so let's summarize one more time. So what we have to do, actually we have to take a start of a sequence, right, and another we will take you can say a sliding window approach, right? So all the elements will move on the sliding window, right? So our goal is to find the last element of the every element, right, in the sequence. Subsequence we will find of the subsequent subarrays, we can say, and we'll keep using the sliding window approach, right, as you can see in the line number 4 and line number 10, right? So we'll keep tracking of that, and then start of the sequence we will keep track of the start, and if the element is not consecutive, we'll update it. Otherwise we'll store on to the result, right, line number 22, and then we'll have our sequence considered valid. It is you can say difference between the end and SOS is equal to k minus 1, then we'll store the last element, and if not, then we have our result empty. Otherwise we'll have the data in the results, and so we can have our complexity thing. So if you see the complexity O of n and the space complexity of O of n minus k plus 1, because this is the size of the results array. Okay, I hope you like this video. In the next video we are going to see maximum value sum by placing the tree rocks one, and we'll see the approach and the solution. Thank you for watching this video.